Human waste. We don't really like to talk about it, but all around the world we have a huge dirty problem. Sewage and wastewater is pouring into rivers and coastal environments, harming human health and ecosystems. All that waste adds around 6.2 million tons of nitrogen to oceans every year. That's about 40% of the amount produced by agricultural runoff. But nitrogen pollution is just the tip of the human waste iceberg. Sewage and wastewater also contain a toxic cocktail of chemicals, including pharmaceuticals, heavy metals, microplastics, along with bacteria. These can make their way from waterways into the food chain, threatening humanity's food supply. Together, these contaminants are threatening rivers, lakes, estuaries, coral reefs, and other marine habitats, spreading disease to aquatic animals and people. Nearly 500,000 people die every year because of the resulting water contamination. Human waste even contributes to climate change by putting seagrass meadows at risk. When these die off, they release the carbon they store into the atmosphere, adding to global warming. So, how can we solve our global human waste problem? To address the problem, we need first to know where all this waste comes from. In many places, particularly in developing countries, a lack of access to basic sanitation and wastewater treatment facilities is a real challenge. Nearly half the world's population doesn't have safely managed sanitation. But waste isn't a problem confined to developing countries. According to one estimate, 80% of human wastewater globally is pumped into the oceans without treatment. In the developed world, wastewater treatment facilities are often outdated or simply not capable of treating or removing the toxic contaminants found in our waste. Caffeine expelled from our bodies after a morning coffee is just one example. Depending on the treatment method used, this substance is only partially removed from wastewater. Its increasing presence in aquatic environments is causing concern among scientists due to its potentially toxic effects on biodiversity. In cities with aging combined sewer overflows, including New York, Chicago, Paris, London, and thousands of other places, heavy rainfall can overwhelm sewage treatment plants, resulting in untreated wastewater and raw sewage flooding into waterways. Many thousands of liters of raw sewage flow into streams and bays every year as a result. Climate change, with its rapidly intensifying violent storms, is already making the problem worse. In 2021, Hurricane Ida and heavy rainfall in its aftermath triggered spills from sewer networks in cities and states across the U.S., from New Orleans, Louisiana, to urban New Jersey, pointing at the scale of this problem. But does all of this waste have to be wasted? Not according to experts. Solutions exist to reduce impacts and even enable our waste to be turned into a valuable resource. The world is already steadily improving sanitation in the developing world, though more needs to be done. Likewise, updating urban sewer systems is possible. Treatment plants can be upgraded or built where they don't exist. Storage space for stormwater can be expanded to reduce the chance of storm overflows. But such projects can be incredibly expensive and take years to implement. Solutions that work with, or are inspired by nature, are perhaps the most promising and cost-effective way to tackle the human waste crisis. Nature-based solutions can green up cities, support existing wastewater infrastructure, or provide sewage treatment to communities who don't have it. So-called living machines can ecologically detoxify wastewater and reduce pressure on aging sewage facilities. New green open spaces, including roof gardens, can reduce storm runoff, decrease flood risk, improve urban air quality, provide homes for wildlife, and be adapted to urban and rural settings. Bangkok, Thailand's Benjakitti Forest Park is one example. Covering 72 hectares, this park absorbs rainwater and treats sewage from the nearby city. Constructed wetlands use plants, gravel, and soil to capture and store stormwater, and to purify wastewater. Like this 6-hectare treatment wetland at Gorla Maggiore Water Park, Italy, that was constructed in 2014 on the site of an abandoned poplar plantation. It supports the treatment of combined sewer overflows wastewater. Rain gardens can also act as an urban sponge, collecting precipitation and stormwater, reducing the chances of overwhelmed sewage plants, and preventing combined sewer overflows from polluting rivers and estuaries. Permeable pavements are another solution. Made from porous rock, these innovative parking lots and roads allow water to trickle through them, rather than running off into sewers and polluting waterways. But that is not all. Reusing human waste and utilizing the valuable nutrients and water that it contains is just one element of a sweeping new vision for human society, known as the circular economy. Fully cleansing wastewater can produce a renewable source of drinking water, which is particularly important for regions facing shrinking water supplies in the face of climate change. And it's being done. Singapore already sources nearly half its fresh water in this way. Many cities across the US are doing the same and have been doing so for decades. Efficient wastewater technologies are also being developed to separate out nitrogen and phosphorus, nutrients harmful to ecosystems, but useful as fertilizer to farmers, allowing reuse before sewage even reaches rivers and oceans. Low-cost and decentralized treatment systems can even be fitted into individual buildings, reutilizing fresh water and even producing energy. Green walls, another nature-based solution, can be added to buildings, allowing treated wastewater to be recycled, further closing the pollution-solution loop. Today, our waste is exacting a heavy toll on the environment and human health. But as vast as this problem is, a huge range of solutions are at hand. By tailoring those solutions to suit local, urban, and rural needs, the impact of our waste can be minimized, and it can even become a source of new life.